Yo, what's going on? What's good, my people? Shit, I just want to make a quick little video on chain setups and shit. Alright, this is my last one. This is the one I tell y'all guys to avoid. They look like this. They real flimsy. They give out pretty fast. And so, I'm changing. So, bam. You want ones like these. You got the big heavy duty one. Like this. And you got the little heavy duty one. Then it's two more sizes down from that too. Like one on for a puppy chain and one on for, you know, you're smaller. No, Adam. Then you got these types. Oh man, I like to run across these. When you out, like this. This is real steel. When you out and goddamn on the bout and you see a flea market or something out middle of nowhere, man, stop. You might come across these for about $5. You could talk them down, but shit, you know, they ain't making too much in that every day. Just sit out there. So just pay for a person, what a person asks for. Unless you like buying a case, then I understand, but you just see one you like too. But yeah, I bought this. I think coming out of Tennessee. Indian type land. Alright. I wanted to put this, but I'm gonna wait till I get some bigger. Alright, that's the spinner, y'all. But I'm using the Mary Jane, plain Jane. Simple. Alright, then you got your clamps. You got these kind. Yeah, I'm back with it. I was getting phone calls all day. What was it? Okay, you got the clothes. Clamps or whatever you want to call them, closed shuts. You got the C clamps and these shuts right here. These all right here go on the other end of the spinner. So boom, like this. Now I prefer these because they know open them back up. These right here fails a lot. They will unscrew. If you're going to use them, I suggest plumber's tape, super glue, let them get a little rusty. But anyway, all you do is put this through the loop. Now that's a little big one. Put it through the loop. Alright. Grab the end of the chain. This already got this on. This stronger than the link. So of course I'm gonna still use that. Chain get a little bit longer. That's why you start off with 6-inch chain. Over the time it is about 8-inch chain. I hate to have them on too small, but 6-inch cool. Especially for very active dogs, 6-inch very cool. Cause they're gonna work themselves in circles anyway. But less active dog, you know, I kind of like a longer chain so they can like move out, go get the water bowl, go get the food bowl, opposite side of the house. So, and another reason, these right here pretty cool. Yeah, I was getting phone calls, man, back to back. So I never could get the video. But anyway, get your pliers on it. Hold on. Let's see. I really need the light. Let's see. can't really see too good. I misplaced my good plies, so bear with me. That's what I usually use plies. Alright. See how I shut it just only a little bit. Right. Then you screw up. You tighten the plies a little bit more. And you get another grip. Just a little bit more. Alright. That's the second time. Now better plies, you get better grip and easier closes, shuts. But this is the way, fellas. This is the one. Getting a little closer. Now let me show you two different ways to close these. Now, this is just one way. See how close it gets? Almost all the way through. Almost all the way down. But you keep inching. You keep inching till it's fully shut. I do about so it won't be so much pressure. Oh yeah, I do about two screws, pop it, two screws, lock it. Alright, see now, she really touching, but I kind of see a little gap. Now, you ain't gonna keep it like that. She's going to come up a little bit. So definitely, it's locked. Side in place. Now, I could just leave that there over the night. Or whatever. But you ain't got to. To each his own. Now, same one. Just use it a little easier. You got your, okay. It's locked onto the chain. That spinner, O-ring. Still got a clamp on it. Don't put that over, I know you wasting it. All right. And you know how some people say, you need, I done pulled a car with one O-ring, so you really don't need, if it's a good O-ring, it's a good one. If it's a bad one, it's a bad one. But a good O-ring, you don't need number one for a dog. You know what I'm saying? If you're going to go pull a car or a truck or something, yeah, you might need two or three. But for a dog, you only need one. The O-ring is most of anybody wear and tear they fails will happen at the spinner. More spinners you have, more mistakes you can make. So I don't suggest the two spinner thing like people do. But this is the second way. It's dark. It would have been a little bit easier in the daylight. Cause I'd have had something. Okay. I got a little spot. Got these rocks coming up out the ground. It's alright. Second way, the quickest way. Fudge hammer. I could do this with one hand. Cause it don't take much. Can't get a square. Oh shit. Don't want to close it like that. Make sure everything. Shit. A little more simple just locking the O-ring, but hey, I want the link on mine too. Try to get it square this time. See that? One pop, all it takes. Alright. So now this has been sitting. And this. Get your set up. Alright. You always want to go backwards. So chain. Closed link. Spinner. Spinner. O-ring. And that'll be your setup, fellas. I'm out.